Hey guys, welcome back to Star Citizen. So ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for joining me for a brand new Star Citizen video. Now I'm going to try and make this a kind of a mini series on my channel. Every couple of months, maybe a couple of weeks, I will do one of these videos. Now you might be wondering, what is this? Well, I want to do a Can You Survive kind of a mini series in Star Citizen. Now a while back, a couple of weeks ago, I did a kind of a survival video on Microtech, where I accidentally, actually I didn't mean to do it, I fell out of a mining ship, the Argo Mole, and I basically tried to walk my way about 20-30 kilometers on the surface of Microtech to a particular outpost, shelter outpost or something like that, or a mining outpost. I just wanted to see if I could survive. Now I'm gonna actually make this an actual thing now, where I go to a particular planet, a particular moon, and try and see if I can survive there. Like basically try and walk 30 kilometers across the surface, make a video out of it. Hopefully it will entertain you guys and it will show you the various different ground features, the updated geology packs and stuff like that on the various different moons. And obviously we're going to be encountering very, very different atmospheric characteristics. For example, Microtech was very, very cold, but the planet that we're going to be seeing today, can you guys guess what it is? Well, you will in a minute, but you guys might be wondering, what the hell are you doing inside a Cutlass Red, Marshall? Well, that's a good question, guys. Well, the Cutlass Red allows you to respawn on these beds, as you guys can see. Now, you might be wondering, why the hell do you need a bed to respawn in? Well, that's a good question, guys. So, I've actually attempted this video over four or five times now. The game has crashed, I've bugged right through the planet, where I fall right through the planet, or something goes wrong. So I've come here in a Cutlass Red, so if in case something goes wrong, like a glitch or something like that, I can just respawn here. But if I die due to, you know, like atmospheric conditions, or I get shot or something like that, no, I'll keep that in the video. But if something gets bugged, there's no point in, you know, keeping it in the video, because that's not really fun, especially at the start of the video. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, we are fully kitted out in this video, guys. This is not like the Microtech video. So this is me trying to survive a particular planet. Now, for those of you who are familiar with Star Citizen, you already know what type of planet I'm talking about based on the undersuit that I'm wearing. Yes, in fact, this is the Pembroke undersuit. So this undersuit is designed, hint hint, for very hot climates. So this suit can withstand up to temperatures of up to 225 degrees Celsius and negative 75 degrees Celsius as well. So we have various different kinds of weapons and everything, which I'll explain later. But without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, let's go ahead and open up the back ramp of the Cutlass Red. Ta-da! So guys, this is the moon of... Do you guys see what I'm saying? Do you guys just have a look? Seriously, guys, did you see that? That almost killed me. That silly thing almost killed me, where the ship is just floating. Anyways, let me go ahead and close that ramp. Even if it doesn't close, who cares? Who cares? Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, it is so frustrating sometimes, guys. It is so frustrating to do videos in Star Citizen. You just want to put your fist through your monitor, or just bash your head against the monitor. But anyways, don't do that. Don't do that. But it's very frustrating to record videos for Star Citizen. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, we are here on Aberdeen. We're here on Aberdeen, one of the moons of Hurston, the planet Hurston. And we're going to see if we can survive out here on this planet, on this moon, I should say, or planet. Let's just call it a planet, for 30 kilometers. Now, you guys may be wondering, what is so special about Aberdeen? Well, there are a couple of different special things about Aberdeen. First of all, Aberdeen is very, very hot. Aberdeen, the surface temperature on Aberdeen, as you guys can see down the bottom left, is 227 degrees Celsius. Now, because we have this suit, it says we can survive for 7 hours and 21 minutes and 7 seconds. Now, there's another really cool thing about Aberdeen, guys. There's a penal colony on Aberdeen, yes. There's that Kleischer rehabilitation/correctional facility here on Aberdeen. Now, I've parked the Cutlass Red in a way where the nose of the ship points exactly to where I want to go. Now, I don't want to go to that penal colony. I want to avoid the penal colony, guys. I'll explain in a minute. But I want to head to this location right here. It is the Barton Flats Aid Shelter. So we are here. If you guys can see on the map, we are right here and we want to make it there. And that's about almost 30 kilometers. Okay, 30 kilometers. Let's see if we can make it. But if we're not careful, we can end up in the restricted zone of the Kleischer Rehabilitation Center, the prison, the penal colony. Okay, so we need to make sure that we walk straight. And as you guys know, there is no navigation system. There's no terrestrial navigational systems for Star Citizen. So we only have this F2 star map to navigate off of, and this is barely good enough to navigate in space, let alone here on the surface of the planet. But anyways, we shall do it. We shall endure the hardships and we shall make it, ladies and gentlemen. Anyways, thank you so much for joining me as always, guys. Let's get this going. Now, why did I choose Aberdeen? First of all, I wanted to choose some place that's really difficult, and this place is difficult. As you guys can see, it's very, very hot. It is extremely hot. Now, the temperature rating is actually higher than what our suit is designed to be able to withstand. So we need to be really careful, because our body core temperature will rise. Our core body temperature will rise and we'll get thirsty. And therefore, why I've packed around 5 or 6, maybe I think it is 10 bottles of water. So I've come prepared. As I said, I've come prepared. Now, right off the beginning, guys, right off the beginning, find a point, find a star or something like that in the sky, and try and align yourself with it and make sure you stay on that. That's how I survived the Microtech hike. Anyways, yeah, so this is Aberdeen. This is Aberdeen. It's a hull hole. And as I said, there's a penal colony on here. So all of the bad people, all the baddies, players, NPCs, everybody are basically locked up here. Basically everybody gets put into that Kleischer Rehabilitation Center. So there's going to be bounty hunters here. There's going to be prison escapees. There's going to be criminal friends of those prison escapees who are coming here to pick them up. So we are very, very likely to run into players. We are very, very likely to be killed by players. So that's why I chose this place. It should be fun. And plus, CIG have updated all of the geology packs for the various different moons and planets and stuff like that. So I wanted to go ahead and show you guys. I'm not sure if they've updated Aberdeen, but yeah, I just want to show you guys the surface of these planets in Hurston. So yeah, I've come prepared, guys. Here's a pistol. Is it LH-86? And I also have this, the brand spanking new A03 sniper rifle. Check it out. Yeah. And I have the 16x scope on it with the zeroing option. Check that out. Pretty cool. And also we have this. No, I didn't want to drop it. Did it drop my sniper rifle? No, I don't think so. Anyway, we have this Behring LMG light machine gun as well, which is really, really cool. And it's fully loaded with ammo. We have 4 extra cans of ammo, so we're good to go. And of course, let me go ahead and show you my personal inventory. I stocked up on water, water. And I've also had some food before we came out here, so we won't need food. Now, what is the difficult thing? What is the confusing thing here? I cannot take off my helmet, guys. So let me go ahead and show you the atmosphere. The atmosphere has pressure. So it's 1.04 atmospheres of pressure. It has salt. NaCl is sodium chloride, so it's almost 1% sodium chloride in the air. This thing, I'm not sure what it is. Sulfur dioxide. Basically, it's poisonous, right? Sulfur dioxide is poisonous, so that's 90% that in the atmosphere. So, and of course, it's hot, 228 degrees and climbing. So if you take off your helmet to eat a drink, you're gonna burn your face. So I'm not sure what's the point of carrying water anyway. But this thing is gonna take a long time, guys. It's gonna take a long, long time. But obviously I'm gonna try and edit the video down to the most interesting parts, so you guys don't have to watch through the whole thing. Yeah. Now the bad thing about this suit is that it's really, really heavy. It gives you a lot of protection, but it's super duper heavy. So that's one of the negatives of this suit, the Pembroke suit. And they have the Novikov one as well, which is designed for colder temperatures, such as Microtech. I believe it can withstand up to negative 220 for that one, and a plus 75 for hotter temperatures. I wonder how this tree survived here. I mean, as you saw, the air is filled with salt and sulfur dioxide and super hot. How does anything grow here anyway? How are these plants surviving? Only God knows. Now, which were my two stars? I was too busy yapping away. I've kind of lost my way. There's the cutlass. I think it was either that. Yeah, I think it was that. It's getting dark. Unfortunately, and also fortunately, the sun has gone down completely now. Completely. Now, unfortunately, because you guys don't get to see the surface of the planet as much, but fortunately, because that means that the temperature will start to decrease as well. Obviously, the temperature goes down at night, but it's still very, very hot. And this is one of the reasons why they have a penal colony here on Aberdeen, because the prisoners will have a really, really hard time trying to escape from the prison. And in fact, many of the players that try to escape from that prison end up just dying on the surface of the planet, unless you have somebody to come and pick you up. So that's why you see in chat a lot of people say like, oh, can you come and pick me up from the prison, so on and so forth. But as I said, there are a lot of bounty hunters, like a lot around here. I know that how, because I've done that myself. When I used to do bounty hunting before, I used to hang around here all the time in my ship, you know, just either land somewhere quietly or just stay up in the air, wait for an escapee mission, and then there we go, you'd go on the hunt. Now, this one time, I was in my Aegis Eclipse, and that's the stealth bomber that fires size 9 torpedoes, and there was this guy, he was escaping from the prison. He made it all the way out of the prison. He got inside an Ursa Rover. It's like a buggy. He got inside that Ursa Rover and he was basically driving as fast as he can towards that aid station. And I found him. I scanned him down. I found him in the Eclipse. I locked him up at like 8 kilometers with a size 9 torpedo. Now, size 9 torpedoes, for those of you not familiar with Star Citizen, is used against the largest of the large ships in the game. But I'm here locking up this small Ursa Rover, basically, this like a little buggy, like a little tiny car. I locked him up and I shot the size 9 missile, and this poor guy has no idea he's being locked. And the missile just flies right into that Ursa Rover, guys. And it had the biggest explosion ever. And it was nighttime, just like this. And the whole area lit up. And I could see the carcass of that Ursa Rover just flipping. It probably done like 20, 30 flips. And it just flew out of the place. It was so funny. It was really, really funny. Probably not very funny for that guy, but funny for me. But yeah, there's bound to be people here. There's bound to be players here looking for PvP, obviously. This place is a PvP hotspot. Okay, guys, welcome back. So an update. So we're 4.3 kilometers away now from the Cutlass Red, so we've traveled 4.3 kilometers. Outside atmospheric temperatures are 2 to 8 degrees Celsius, 228 degrees Celsius. I'm not sure if I've explained this before, but oh, there we go. Oh, have a look. O2 tank is at 32%. So we're running low on oxygen in our tank. So I'm not sure if I explained this before, but actually water starts to boil at 100 degrees. So water starts to boil at 100 degrees Celsius. Right now, the outside temperature is 228 degrees Celsius. This is absolutely crazy. This place is hellish. This place is definitely hellish. But it has some spectacular night views, guys, of the whole galaxy, of the stars. But yeah, in terms of surviving, the suit says we can survive for another 5 hours and 49 minutes. In terms of vegetation and stuff like that, it's just deadfall kind of things, like, you know, dead trees and shrubs and, you know, like these kind of things, plants. But I'm not sure how they survive. How do they manage to survive at temperatures this high? You know, it's absolutely crazy. So let's go ahead and give ourselves an oxygen shot. Basically, it replenishes the oxygen in the tank. So let's go ahead and do that. There we go. That's one. And again. Come on. You can do it. Apparently not. Who knows? Who knows, guys? So yeah, still heading towards the stars, the two stars, and we'll see you guys either if something interesting happens or something goes wrong. I mean, that could be interesting as well, right? So anyways, I'll see you guys later. Where are we? And guys, can I say, like, I'm not sure if you agree with me, but I hate this F2 menu. Like, CIG, if any of you guys, please, if any of the developers are watching this, which is highly unlikely, but if you're watching this video, this is the next thing that has to get done in the game. This F2 navigation menu is absolutely atrocious. It's horrible. And I'm not just talking about, like, on-planet navigation. Just please, even ship navigation, space navigation, this is awful. It's absolutely awful. I know you're waiting on the new UI thing, but anyways. Barton Flats 8 Shelter, 23 kilometers, guys. 23.5, 23.6 kilometers till we get there. Now, one thing that's really, really cool about this game, guys, about Star Citizen, is that it has that flare effect where if you are looking at a bright screen, then you obviously all of a sudden you're looking at a dark location. It takes time for your eyes to adapt. It has that adaptive feature, which is really, really cool. Not a lot of games have this. But yeah, the navigation menu, oh guys, that's awful. That is awful. The worst thing about Star Citizen, in my opinion, besides the crashes, is that that menu. That thing is atrocious. Oh, there we go. Oxygen low again. So if you start running, your oxygen depletes faster. And I don't think it can regenerate. So you're going to have to bring in a lot of those oxygen pens. Almost 7 kilometers. 22, 23 kilometers to go. I'll see you guys later. Okay, guys, welcome back. So, something really bad just happened. Our core body temperature just went up from 36.4 to 36.5. I mean, that's gonna put a wrench through the whole survival plan, because if that core body temperature keeps going up, it's like having a fever. Basically at 40 degrees, at 40, 41 degrees, you just pass out and you die. So I need to, so it's like a catch 22, it's like a double-edged sword. Do you run faster, you lose oxygen faster, or you walk slower but risk getting overheated? That's the thing. Now, do not take off your helmet. Even if you take off your helmet for just a couple of seconds, guys. Whoa, that's gonna, like, it's, it'll make you half health, a quarter health, if you take off your helmet for anything more than, like, 5 seconds. Am I following the right stars? I think I'm lost. But I think it's this way. I think that's the two stars. I'm not sure, guys. I'm not sure. Yeah, I don't think we're going to survive this one. I'm going to say it. I'm going to say it right now. I don't think we're going to survive this. Oxygen at 17%. Don't worry, I have the oxygen shots. The oxygen pens. How many kilometers? 7.2. Okay. But that core body temperature, the one in the middle. Oh my god, it's 32 degrees now. External temperature is going up. How can it be? How can it be hotter in nighttime than it is during the daytime? You guys hear the character taking deeper and deeper breaths because we're running out of oxygen. You guys hear that? Uh-oh. Wow, it just got red. It's in 12%. Alright, let's stop. Let me go to the... We have 2 minutes and 22 seconds of oxygen. Oh, God. Alright, the equipment manager, utility, oxygen. There we go. We just have to keep using these oxygen pens. Your oxygen tank is very low. Oh, okay. Come on. Come on now. There we go. And again. Nice. Let's go ahead and equip some more oxygen pins. So make sure if you want to do this in Aberdeen, you take as many oxygen pins as you can. And of course, I'd say bring water, but you have to take off your helmet to drink water, so... Yeah. Anyways, let's continue. Onwards! I think it's that way. Hopefully we'll get there before that core body temperature reaches 40 degrees. Or if the external atmospheric temperatures drop below 225, which is what the suit is rated at. Now, if it drops below 225, we'll be able to survive pretty much for a long time, for a very, very long time. But as you guys can see, it's 232 degrees, so it's about 7 degrees above what the suit is rated for. But you guys get a good idea of how hellish this place is. Wow. Alright, how many kilometers? Almost 8 kilometers. Let's go ahead and check the navigation menu. We are 22 kilometers. You guys can see how long it takes to walk in this game. It's just, it takes forever. It absolutely takes forever. Alright, I've lost my stars. Oh, there we go. There we go. That way. So, next time when you're in your ship and you're flying at a couple of thousand meters per second across a planet or in space, when you're quantum flying, just spare a thought for how crazy large this game's gameplay area is, because it's absolutely mind-boggling to think about it. I mean, you don't feel how large the gameplay area is in this game until you start walking. And that's how it is in real life too. Like 30 kilometers, I'm not sure if any of you guys have ever walked 30 kilometers on foot, but I have. I have, and 30 kilometers literally takes forever. It's 30 kilometers at an average walking distance, not running, walking, will probably be like 3 hours. 3 hours. So, yeah, that's how it is in this game as well. So yeah, unless you come out here on these planets and you actually walk a certain distance, then you won't appreciate how large this game is, how large the play area for this game is. Although most of it is probably just useless space. I mean, there's nothing here. Like, I haven't come across a single thing, and I've been walking for like way over like 35 minutes. So anyways, I'll see you guys once we're closer. Now we're at 38 degrees internal body temperature, core body temperature. We have a pretty bad fever now. I mean, if you think about it, guys, colder climates are much more friendlier and less hostile to survive in than hotter temperatures. Like, for example, the coldest place on Earth is like 80 something degrees, right? And it's like an actual inhabited place, not like an inhabited place. Like an actual place where people live is like negative 80 degrees, I believe, or something around there. And people live there, animals live there. They, obviously it's cold, they have to wear warmer stuff, but it's not too bad. However, do you see anybody or anything living in temperatures of 80 degrees plus? I know we have algae and certain bacteria that can live in hot springs and stuff like that. I'm not talking about that kind of life forms. I'm talking about like people, species like us. We will never survive temperatures, higher temperatures, but we can always survive colder, lower temperatures. So colder weather is generally better than hotter weather, in my opinion. It's in fact good for your body. Like, colder temperatures are good for your body, obviously to an extent. Like, if you expose yourself to too much freezing weather, you'll go into hypothermia. But in our case, in this game right now, we're facing hyperthermia. There we go. It says you are too hot and hyperthermia is beginning to set in. And our survival estimate just dropped down to 14 minutes. So we only have 14 minutes to live, to survive pretty much. And I don't think we're going to make it, unfortunately. Which sucks. Absolutely sucks. We only have this much to go, guys. This much. Just this much. Normally when I'm 19 kilometers away from something, I begin to drop my landing gear. Unless this temperature drops, we're not gonna make it. No matter what we do. Yeah, that estimate, that survival estimate just keeps dropping. There's nothing that I can do to lower that temperature, I don't think. Drinking water, I don't think it's got anything to do with us. Just speaking of water, there we go, the hydration level just started to drop to 90, 99, 98. But that really doesn't do much for us anyway. I don't think it will do much, but I'm going to give it a try anyway. I'm going to give it a try, guys. Personal inventory, come on. Alright, there we go. Alright, before we do that, we have to unequip the helmet and really quickly take a drink. And it goes dark, personal inventory, our face is burning, come on. Come on, drink, quick. We're dying, guys. Come on. Come on. I don't care. I'm putting the helmet back on. Come on, put the helmet back on. Come on. Put the helmet back on. Ooh, zero health. Come on. Come on, give me some of that health. Ooh. 0 health, guys. 0 health. That took forever. That bloody water thing took forever. But it did give it did cool us down just slightly. So I'm gonna do it again. Alright, here we go again. Now, is it better if I grab the water first? Carry. It did cool us down a little bit. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. Grab the water. Grab the water. Come on. Jeez. Alright, unequip. There we go. Yeah, you should grab the water first, guys. Grab the water first. And then unequip the helmet. Come on, drink, 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 drink. There we go. Equip helmet. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Come on. Equip helmet. Oh. That didn't do anything for the temperature, guys. It made it worse. That made it worse. So we're pretty much doomed, guys. We are doomed. There's nothing that we can do to survive. You guys see the screen going all weird? This is not good. Let me go ahead and equip. Let me go ahead and equip some medical pens, oxygen pens. There we go. What's going on? Equip the helmet. Oh my god, was the helmet off? Oh, this sucks. Oh, that sucks. How the hell did the helmet come off? There we go. That just sucks so bad. Did you guys see that? Like, I had my helmet equipped, and then when I went to the equipment manager, it just took off the helmet for some weird reason. This sucks. But there's nothing I can do. It was probably better if I just kept running. If I just kept running, it'd probably be better. But hang on, let me see. Has it actually equipped my helmet, or... No? Holy... So, did I not have a helmet equipped this whole time? I'm pretty sure I did. Oh, God. Oh, this is so bad. We're gonna die, guys. We're gonna die. We're not gonna make it. 3 minutes. 3 minutes. And that's it. Come on. That external temperature thing is just not dropping. I can hear his heartbeat. Boom, 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 boom. Now, if there was a player here, would they spot this? They probably would spot that, right? But there's nothing that they could do, really. It looks like we're not gonna make it, guys. It looks like we're not gonna make it. How many kilometers have we gone? 13. Although, we did waste some time, so... It was smarter just to keep going. Forget about the water thing. And that whole helmet thing, God. As I said, guys, recording videos in Star Citizen is very, very frustrating. Very, very frustrating to actually create content for this game. That's why, actually, I should say, like, gameplay content. But if you're going to talk about game mechanics, or if you're just generally going to talk about the game or a particular ship, that's not too bad. But if you want to make gameplay content in this game, good luck. Good luck with that. They should make flares. They should make, like, flares that you can... Distress flares, I should say. Distress flares. They could probably hear that. There could be players that could hear that. You'd almost certainly hear that within 10, 12 kilometers. guys, 50 seconds and we die. There's nothing that I can do. Probably try another shot of water. Come on, I only have 30 seconds. Carry the water, come on. 20 seconds. Oh God, we're gonna die. 15 seconds. He's got the water. Drink it. Oh, he's dying. There we go. Equip the helmet. Equip the damn helmet. Whoa, we just came back from the brink of death, guys. We were on the brink of death. Holy hell, this is ugly. What's going on? You guys hear that? He's dying of hypothermia. Even if we don't die of thirst, there's nothing that I can do to cool myself down. Oh, this is so bad. Well, so yeah, the lessons from this video, don't try and survive a 30 kilometer walk on Aberdeen, because you won't survive. Even with the best undersuit on, you're still gonna die. Still gonna die. I'm gonna try one more time with the water. That was so close. It was like within like 10 seconds. Alright, here we go again. Let's go again. Carry the water. It takes so long for him to pull out the bottle. Come on. Alright, unequip the helmet and start drinking. Drink. There we go. Equip helmet. Oh, this is so terrible. Give myself some health. Did that do anything? Gave us another 2 minutes, but let me see if I can do it again. Let's see if it adds up. Come on. All right, carry. It takes forever for this guy to grab the bottle. Come on. Chop. Bottle. Oh, you stupid game. we go. Equip helmet. I'm gonna see if that cools me down, guys. Better. Better. But we're almost dead in terms of health. I gotta get some health. No, no, no. Come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on, come on. No, 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 not that, not that. Come on. Oh, this is so terrible. Come on, 2%. Come on. Aww. And we're dead. We're dead, ladies and gentlemen, we failed. Okay guys, welcome back. So here we are, we're back in the Cutlass Red. We respawned back inside this bed, but we failed. That's the main thing, guys, we failed. We absolutely failed. We absolutely failed miserably. We failed miserably. But, however, I'll say this in my own defense. the helmet, every time you equip and unequip the helmet using this menu, right? It once you re-equip it, right? We take it off and put it back on. But when you go into your equipment manager, the game is bugged in that way that it considers the helmet off. So during that time period, you get exposed to the atmosphere, your health goes down, your body temperature goes up, your core body temperature goes up. So yeah, anyways, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for watching this episode of Star Citizens. Can we or can I survive planet XYZ? In this case, let's just call this, can I survive Aberdeen? Can I survive Aberdeen? Or surviving Aberdeen. we'll come up with a name for this series. Well, I'll just call it surviving Aberdeen. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, thank you very, very much, as I said, for watching this video. If it was entertaining to you, if it was informative for you, go ahead and leave a like and go ahead and subscribe if you haven't done so already. Anyways, thank you so much for watching, guys. And oh yeah, just before I close out the video, I forgot to tell you guys this. If you have any recommendations for the various different planets or whatever, where I should go next, go ahead and write it down in the comments sections, where you want me to go next, which planet should I go and visit next. And also, give this a try yourself, or let me know if you have tried this yourself and you have survived Aberdeen. Give it a try, see if you can survive, see if you can do it better than me. Anyways, ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for watching. Please take care, be safe, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye bye. We'll